Okay, so now we're upstairs. This is a future kitchen. We're in the middle of a major renovation, so it's actually quite graphic to show you the old lighting and the new lighting combination. But I also want to show you a little bit more about these panels and how they and the different sizes that are available. You can get them in shorter, wider for a 24-inch center joist. You can get them for a 16-inch center, and you can also get them for 12-inch center. And the different lengths. The reason for the different lengths is that you might have you might have bridging or pot lights within the ceiling that limit the amount of space that you have. So these panels are quite good at fitting the existing space. But you can see they're all of the same same design. It's a drywall product, and the radiant coiling is run through the drywall. So it's all non-flammable, and they don't get that hot, just in around 100 degrees. And they sit, as I mentioned, above the drywall, sitting actually on the drywall, and that will then disperse the heat. So this heats the drywall, and the drywall will then disperse the radiant heating. Now it's up in the ceiling. People will ask, well, heat rises, so why are you starting with the heat up in the ceiling? The actual fact is warm air rises. Heat does not rise. Just like the sun, it's billions of miles away, and yet it heats up the rocks on the beach. The exact same principle is applied here. Because the rays are directional, what actually makes the rays move in different directions is the paint on the ceiling. Because it's a rough surface, it actually transfers the rays in multiple directions. So it's heating the floor, it's heating the walls, it heats the furniture, it heats your body, it heats the countertops. And because all the surfaces are being heated, that in turn is heating the air, so it's a very comfortable, even heat throughout the room. And of course, again, the nice thing is that every room can be set up on a separate zone. In this particular house, we have two furnaces. One is down the hall, and then one is central. What quite often happens with a two-furnace system is they start competing with each other. Or possibly one thermostat is kicking on and off one system, and the other one is staying off because the thermostat is being affected. In this case, we have the furnace down the hall kicking on. It sucks all the air to this part of the house, and this one kicks on and sucks the air back into this part of the house. So it's a total imbalance. So let's just get rid of the furnace altogether. We're gonna retrofit each one of these rooms with these heating panels. So I'm just going to show you how these panels sit in the ceiling so you get an idea of where they fit.